muckers. Here we are in the little village of Mucheley on the levels. Just across the road there is the old priest house. I think somebody's living in there now. It's a monument. Nice thatched cottages. Looks a very old and interesting church, this one. Very old graves. First view of the church. Let's see if we can go inside and take a look around. Here we are inside the church. All the pews got doors on. Very old steps behind glass. The cobwebs up there. No one's been through there for a very long time. says on here, for nothing will be impossible with God. Take a stone from the pile in the font, and as you hold it, think of those burdens you carry in your soul, for feel its weight as it warms in your hand. Allow yourself to feel held by God. If you wish to place a stone on the small pile at the foot of the font, or keep it with you. I don't know what this is, but I will try and find out. The ceiling. It's got angels on the ceiling. On the bell tower directly above us. like some sort of stone in the wall. Lots of oak doors in this building. It's really nice with the sun coming through the stained glass at the top. Find a cupboard. The old light switches beside them. A picture of the church. There's Ted hiding in the way. Says in February 2014, I was given this by a child from Frome to comfort the people of this village as they struggled with the floods. Please leave me here to go on watching over them. That's a nice gesture. I suppose there would have been some statues set on the shelves there many years ago. Church table. I suppose they could tell us a few stories. Go back this way. No doors on these. They still fit perfectly. I call that good craftsmanship. So now you look at the ceiling. A lot of detail gone into that. Topless end user in the church, that's unusual. Let's go down here. Take a look. Look at the detail that's going into these carvings on the end of the pews. Says this blower was put into place for the memory of Kenneth Frank Beckley and Henry Albert Pope, who gave their lives in World War II. May they rest in peace. Take my hat off to you guys. I think it's a pretty little church. So we've got two organs. One there, and one over here. Says donated by John Gibson. Memory of her sister Gladys Jennings, 2011. Lovely handrail, look at the carvings on them. Spindles up. And brass handrail. Beautiful. Nice looking pipes on the organ, nice colours. Look at this painting. Look at the detail in that. It's really, really old. Please do not walk on the tiles. Must be very old tiles. Try and look them up when I get back home. Let's just take one more look at the steps behind the glass. What's this? famous ceiling was painted in the 1600s. I believe the small panels. Above the windows, the stained ones, are 1200 AD. Right, let's just have a look at these stairs again. Okay, that's it inside. Let's go outside and take a look around now, shall we? We are back outside. Let's take a look around the graveyard. Nice old tree as well. Look at the old gargoyle. It's probably seen a lot of changes over the years. Just can't quite read this. Is it? Here lies the body of Joseph Flatford, who died October the 4th in the year of our Lord 1699. These are really worn away. I came this way a couple of months ago, and the road was closed off because all the levels was flooded. So every time they have floods, they gotta close the road off till the floods are, till the flood level drops again. I can't read this one. So old. This is interesting. Again, I can't read what it says there. I wonder if it has to do with someone who's a sailor anchoring a chain. Loving memory of William Pipe Beckley, who died February the 19th, 1929, aged 73, also of his seven children. We've got George Beckery, he died March 26, 1894, aged 50 years old. Some very old graves again. No, one been smashed up. So it's sacred to the memory of Mary Jane Gent, who died the 12th of September 1940, aged 86 years. Also Winifred Blackmore Gent, her son, who died 27th of February 1938, aged 47 years. Also Emily Lady Cannon, her daughter, who died the 27th of May 1939, age 57. can watch while I'm walking there. There's owls everywhere. Rabbits or whatever. This one's nice and clear. You'll be able to read that yourself. Right, I just want to show you something. It's not open yet. I don't think it opens until later this month. But this is Muchelney Abbey. And providing you can take videos in there. I'm hoping to pop in there sometime later on next month. It looks a really interesting place. And hopefully you'll be able to see it. Nice coated cross. Can't make this one out, but they died in 1890, age 72. Somebody's escaped. other body snatchers been about, who knows. Didn't spot that door when we was inside the church. I wonder if it's the outside door to the tower. Looks very much like that. Treasured memories of Derek, beloved son of Selena and John Kay, husband of and wife of husband of Betty, the father of Colin, who fell asleep October 1960, age 26. That's a big tree. I say that's a big tree. These are our more recent graves, 1950s and 60s. Oh, hang on. I thought it was a war grave, but it's not. Maybe we'll just read that one again. Another gargoyle watching me. Let's just see what the sign is on the priest house. Yes, the sign just says it's a private house, but the gardens are open from September onwards. So that's for another day, maybe. Right. So that's it from Muchelney in Somerset on the levels, Muckers. Hopefully we will be able to go in the Abbey and take a look around when it's opened. I'm sure they allow some filming in there. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please press the like button and subscribe maybe, and I'll see you soon again, Muckers. Cheers.